Good day, dear Tango friends. Last night I had my online course CPT and I created a pattern in a hexagon with a C shape. And I would like to show you how I've drawn it, how I've done it. It starts off with drawing in a hexagon, and for me the most easiest way is to draw it between some lines. It starts off with a zigzag line, and about this measure we mirror the shape. Now let's get my inky pen. And let's turn it into hexagons by adding the horizontal lines. And I thought, well, since there are kind of eyes in here and it's made from C shapes, I thought, well, let's name it C U. Next step is to point out the center of each hexagon. I always forget one shape. that's nice. That's weird or nice or whatever. The next step is to draw, and maybe it's easier for you if you give yourself a little line. And for me it's easier to turn my tile. And let's draw C shapes around each black circle. But they won't be all the same. Some will be standing up, some will be laying down. Well, it's up to you what you like most. I think it's nice to have this one standing up and that one laying down. So I skip this one and draw the other one here. Skip this one, draw the other one here. I turn my tile and I will do this one like this. That's all up to you. You can, figure that out yourself, which way you want the eyes to be. You can play with that too. And this one too. Next I did was drawing small C shapes, like little rice corn. They're coming out of that little point of the two C shapes. Here they connect. Here they connect too. It's a tiny one. And I turn my tile And do the same here. And I think they're all done. Sure, I haven't forgotten one. The next step is to aura this line like this. An even amount of lines on each side. Now I got two. Well, let's do a third. Next step is, and I will take the large one, because you can, it's clear for you to see. You see this little bow and that corner we connect and fill that in. Like here, that little bow and that little corner we connect and fill it in. This way. That way, and some are bigger, some are smaller. It's nice to have some variety. So let's first do all the ones in landscape. We turn our towel. And we do the same. And the final, still focused, no, go up, so way better. I think I got them all. Let me check. Yes, I did them all. Well, the next thing to do is I keep those ribbons like this. So these are finished. But with the other shapes, let me be focused. I draw little points and fill these in. And to be sure to go in the right direction, remember pointing to the eye. And when you meet another one, it's nice to have these points connect. So be sure to draw your points in the right way. So here, well, I can color this one, and here this one connects to that one, pointing to the eye. And that's it. And of course, you can embellish it any way you like. Well, what shall I do? Shall I give it some color? Well, let me first get rid of the pencil lines. Thank you for helping me. Well, some color might be nice. Now, the only thing I want to do is give it some shading. I'm using a 4B pencil, which is quite soft. I'm just going over the colors. And that's what CPT is. We offer you tools, basic patterns, base patterns, and techniques to create your own patterns. It awakens the designer in you. It really does. Everybody can draw. Really. Everybody. Pattern see you by me. Happy day, happy tangling. I hope you like it. Wishing you a happy weekend with lots of fun. Stay safe. Bye-bye.